The purpose of this video is to help you understand why the approximate t-value of 2.00 in an absolute sense, so both positive and negative, keeps occurring in the context of me suggesting that a t-value is statistically significant. Now, you may recall from the one sample t-test section of the textbook, I created a t-value distribution with 4,999 degrees of freedom. So that was actually based on a sample size of 5,000 in the context of a one sample t-test. And I pointed out that this t-distribution looks very close to the z-distribution. And we know the z-distribution is associated with z-scores of 1.96, both positive and negative, which demarcate 5% of the total distribution. So what I mean by that is that if you look at the values here in this section of the distribution, so this is where 1.96 would fall, so everything on this side here corresponds to 2.5% of the distribution, and everything that falls lower than negative 1.96 on this side is 2.5% of the distribution. And I know this is true because I calculated the percentiles on this t distribution with 4,999 degrees of freedom, and I found that 1.96 negative is what corresponded to the 2.5 percentile, which is down here. 1.96 would be about here. So these are 2.5%, and 97.5 corresponds to 1.96 in the t-distribution, so 95%, which only leaves 2.5% on the upper end of the distribution. So 1.96 would fall right about here. So everything on this side. So the t-distribution and the z-distribution correspond to each other very closely when the sample size is large. And in this case, the sample size in the context of one sample t-test is 5,000. Well, the same exact rule applies to the two-sample independent sample t-test. The only difference is that the degrees of freedom are based on n minus 2 rather than n minus 1. So that's really the only difference between using a calculated t-value to compare against the t-distribution associated with the specified degrees of freedom. So the value of approximately 2, which is 1.96, rounded up, is the reason why I keep mentioning that, or I mention 1.96 as a calculated t-value that suggests to me that it's probably going to be statistically significant dependent on the sample size. Now, the reason I say depending on the sample size is because the t-distribution changes as a function of the number of degrees of freedom. So when the degrees of freedom are very large, the t-distribution corresponds to the z-distribution very closely. But this distribution here, which could be the t-distribution that we compare a calculated independent sample t-test to, is very narrow and positively kurtotic. And we can see that the corresponding percentiles of 2.5 and 97.5 are associated with t-values much bigger than 1.96. They're actually 2.76, positive and negative. So we can see here that the distribution's tails are fatter on the ends of the distribution, and so a much larger t-value needs to be observed in order to declare it statistically significant, in the sense that only 5% of t-values are equal to that or larger. So that's why I have to say approximately 2, depending on the degrees of freedom or sample size, because with very low sample sizes, 1.96/2-ish doesn't really work. The t-value must be much bigger than that. But in practice, people do not conduct studies with degrees of freedom of 4. That would suggest the sample size for the one sample t-test is only 5, or in the context of a two sample independent sample t-test, that it's equal to 6. Most of the time, people have something closer to 49. So this is the t-distribution that researchers are often comparing their calculated t-value against. And we can see that a negative 2.02 t-value, which is about right here, occurs 2.5% of the time. So the t-value is a little bit bigger than the 2, and that's certainly a little bit bigger than the 1.96 that we saw when the sample size is massive, and it's corresponding essentially to the z-distribution. So when you're dealing with practical sample sizes that you see in practice, which is probably 25 or more, sometimes you have more, and so the distribution starts to look more and more like the t-distribution. But in this case here, this is why I have to say approximately 2, is because it's mostly true, except when your sample size is really small, like it is here. I can't say approximately 2 here. It's closer to 2.76. But again, most people don't do research with that sample size. So overall summary, when you see a calculated t-value, whether it's from a one-sample t-test or a two-sample t-test, and that t-value is approximately 2, and the sample size is probably about 50 overall, then you should be starting to think that that t-value is statistically significant. Stated alternatively, that a t-value that large or larger from a repeated sampling perspective would not be expected to be observed very often. In fact, it would probably be less than 5% of the time.